Now, I'm going to take my time, and I'm not going to be up here long, but I'm going to take my time and really go through this like I want to, because this is very near and dear to me, coming from Charleston County, where we boast over 400,000 people. And I told you the numbers because we could go from A to Z at any given moment when it comes to issues. Now, I've heard a lot of people come up to this well and talk about our founding fathers. Well, like many of you, I'm a historian. I like to read the real history about our founding fathers. Because a lot of you know, when they wrote the Constitution, they were in a place where they had wild parties, orgies, getting high. Yeah, it's funny. You see, it's funny, but it's a fact. I'm trying to get you to quit putting these founding fathers on a pedestal. They were human, okay? Some of them owned slaves. I wanted that to sink in. Because we get up here and we want to be so patriotic, but we don't want to face reality. And reality is me, to me, is some of you came to Charleston doing the Emanuel 9, the Walter Scott. You held hands with my members. You cried with them. You prayed for change. And you know the cry in Charleston. Gun reform, common sense gun laws. That's the cry that came out of Charleston. But yet you want to take us back to the 16th, 17th century. How dare you? That's an insult to all the lives that were lost before the Mother Emanuel and all the in-betweens with gun violence. People, let me tell you something. In South Carolina, and I'm glad that the representative just before me, because he stated it well. How dare we even come in these chambers knowing that road rage is out of the roof. And if you study the FBI report, there are now 19 hate groups in South Carolina and growing. Blake, I'm gonna ask you to put that film up there. Can you show that picture? I want y'all to see something. See, this to me is reality. See, we think it's a joke. You got the wife out on a nice day with the children. You just want to go in a store, restaurant, you know, movie. See, you know, movie theater. You know about the Aurora situation and all that good stuff we coming off here in this country. But yet, you want my citizens from Charleston and in South Carolina, all of South Carolina, to look at this. Situations like this. Yeah, let me tell you something. There will be more funerals. Lives will be cut short. The Aurora situation is going to look like a cartoon of sorts. And I see some of my peers walking around smiling. See, you don't come to the funerals. You don't get the phone calls. You know, you think it's funny. Some of you just got here. You know, and we do believe in one thing up here is respect. Okay, because I didn't see you down at Mother Emanuel, and I don't expect you to be there. My point is, people, we're up here knowing that law enforcement is against this bill. I talked to Chief Mullen. You know, back in the city of Charleston, we boast over 450 law officers, police, black women, white women, Jews, protecting us. They don't want this. People of all creeds and color. So why are we entertaining this? We're gonna put law enforcement in the crosshairs. You're putting their lives in danger. Why? We already pay taxes for their services. They have the proper training. And believe me, there ain't no 1 week or 2 weeks. Man, look here, people, you gotta let the past go sometimes in the South with all this You know, Ben and the boys are gone now. They're dead in their grave. They did some good things. And I tell you, our biggest problem in this country, minorities, as to the second, are trying to prove that when they wrote the Constitution, they made it for everybody. Because if we weren't out there protesting, losing our lives to say, wait a minute, we the people, not we the white people or the black people or the purple people, is they wrote we the people. Now, what's wrong? How simple. And we're going to put now, we want the state of South Carolina to go back. We're beckoning for more Mother's Emanuel. We're beckoning for more rioting because hate groups love to intimidate. That's their job. This scene is going to be relevant, what you see to my right and my left. Now, some of you probably have never been caught up in tragedies in your district. But dog it, when you are, you're going to learn a lesson. It's like some of my parents got up here and said, and they had an epiphany. Oh, the doctor says I'm just going to last 24 hours. If I did anything to wrong anybody, forgive me. So y'all remember those situations. Well, why are we up here sending people to their early graves? And let's talk, and let me say this, and nobody has discussed this yet. Every time I pick up the Post and Courier, I read about all these guns going into homes, and little Johnny and little Sue blowing their mother's brains out, or little Sue blowing little Johnny's brains out. Y'all think this is funny? Nobody wants to talk reality. Everybody want to get up here and be patriotic so Ben and the boys can smile. Don't do that, people. Don't sell our people short. And when I say our people, I'm talking about the 4 million plus here in the state of South Carolina. Time is important. The people are watching us. If this bill passes, the people back in Charleston got a name for it, the blood bill, because that's all it is. It's the blood bill. 1862, the Homestead Act. I say that to say this. Now, when those towns were created back during the Homestead Act, the sheriff had to tell everybody, when you come in this town, you turn your weapons in at the sheriff's office. That's what we used to call martial law. You see, you know why? Because they used to strap on their guns and go around intimidating people. I am bad. You ever talk to a psychiatrist like that? Many psychiatrists will tell you, when you have a gun on your person and you go out to happy hour, you're gonna come out and go look for trouble. That's what we're setting up here. Y'all need to talk to these people. Let's talk reality. You're putting our law enforcement in the crosshairs, yet alone the innocent bystanders. You can train a person to shoot for a week, 3 weeks, a month. Guess what? They ain't had no military training. It ain't no important to you nor me in our society. We got a military for a reason. We got our police departments for a reason. I put my faith in them, even with the troubles we have. We don't need no vigilantes. You know, it's sad that when Mr. Cannon and Mr. Gatlin came along in our society, first thing or the first people that lost was the Native Americans. It's sad. I know the history. It's sad for me to stand here knowing that a retired police chief, who I have high respect for, is going to put this state under damnation.
What's your name? There's too many of you crying. Brother, 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 there's far